Tea has life. It is reborn annually. Sometimes, a chance is all it needs for a tea leaf to stretch. The taste is the beginning of the century-old story of the tea industry in Taiwan. The story starts right at the beginning of the development of Taipei. Da Dao Cheng was originally a crops drying farm along the Danshui River. It became a commercial port in the Qing Dynasty. The foreign merchants promoted the tea export trade. Da Dao Cheng emerged as a commerce and trade center in the north. In the golden age of tea, all the ups and downs remained in an old mansion. After 100 years, the sunlight still falls on the red brick and gray walls, and the whispering light and shadow are swaying the traces of the time. The courtyard is still serene and bustling outside. The former resident was Chen Tianlai, a tea tycoon in Da Dao Cheng at that time.
它是对称的，左右两边有两个塔，它采用了当初100年前高级的前卫的钢筋混凝土的构造的技术，而且引入了各式各样精美的华丽的装饰，包含这个仿巴洛克形式的泥塑。
Turning back the time, Chen Tianlai, who was less than 20 years old, followed his father Chen Zesu to supply charcoal to the tea shop in Da Dao Cheng. Inspired by John Dodd and Li Chuncheng, Chen Tianlai founded Jingji Tea Company in 1891.
当时大道城那边，这个丁阿卡就非常非常多的茶工来挑茶检查，整个人山人海。他把当时曾经所学到的包花茶的水准精致之后呢，他卖到东南亚卖得非常非常的好，所以呢，他的整个事业版图就不只是在台湾跟中国大陆，而且他还扩及到整个南洋地区。
Chen Tianlai served as the chairman of the Tea Merchants Association and promoted the tax reduction. The former residence is a historical place where tea merchants and celebrities met in the heyday of Da Dao Cheng. The spatial form reflects the tea merchant culture. The first floor is a banquet hall for reception, and the staircase is luxurious. Walking up to the second floor is the traditional atrium, and there is a VIP room next to it with many antique treasures. The antique master chair is inlaid with mirrors. The furniture was mainly made of old black mahogany, sandalwood, and red juniper. And this double-waisted table is meticulously crafted by woodwork. The worship hall on the third floor is also exquisite. The backyard garden is even more palatial. When it was Chen Tianlai's 60th birthday, all his descendants reunited to leave a precious page.
他就不忘本，不管在家里或者在外面跟朋友，他也常常提到说，以前李尊生怎么提拔他，让大家觉得他是一个很诚实可靠的人。哦，也。
During the Second World War, the business of Jingji Tea Company was seriously hit. Chen Tianlai died of illness in 1939. The funeral service was mourned honorably. It symbolized the end of one era and the beginning of another era. Let the old and the new meet to construct Da Dao Cheng's cultural charm. The old house recorded the history of Taiwan's tea industry. It was designated as a municipal monument in 2006. However, due to the complex inheritance of property, the family has had different opinions on restoration, which led to desertion for more than 10 years. After the Department of Cultural Affairs intervened in coordination, an example for revitalization was set, and the final consensus was reached. The monument was kept by the government and the private sector working together.
这栋古厝经由文化局的这么的用心的安排，然后这么多年来一直不断的开会，一直希望我们陈家的人可以把这栋古厝呈现给大家。如果在四年多以后完成的话，正好是我们这栋古厝100年的历史，我觉得是个蛮骄傲的一件事情。
The most touching thing is what moved people in the past through the old house will be left to the future. The stories of Da Dao Cheng, tea merchant.And Chen Tian Lai have not been forgotten. Revival of the old house connects the past and the future, perhaps just like an ordinary morning. The sun is shining, the door is open, and everyone gathers and talks. We are in the old house, serving tea.